Get ready to match the stars. Della Reese. Richard Dawson. Arlene Francis. Bob Barker. Michael Learned. And Richard Thomas. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now, here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, ready? How do you do? How do you do? Is everybody in the mood for fun and games?
We're back to
we'll play this top for what we did yesterday.
You what?
You tied that.
I tied that. How can you tell I tied that? I did indeed tie that.
You did. Same.
I wouldn't. Did you tie yours?
I can tell. It's all. You can always tell.
They look rotten.
That's right. That's they always come out.
Okay. I guess you are ready for whatever you're ready for. Now I'd like you to meet our two players. Here are Geeta Satyendra and Helene Harrington. Now this lady, you'll remember. Celebrities is our current champ. She's won two games. She has a total of $700 to her credit. She's happy about that. And Helene, in this game where you're in the middle of the second round, she's ahead 1-0. Of course, you must score match one celebrity to stay in the running. However, you could win it with two. We'll pick up right where we left off last time, immediately after this. All right, let's see what happens here as we finish this game. Are you ready, ladies? We are in the middle of round two. Scores 1-0, favor of Helene, our challenger. Geeta, you must match one celebrity to stay in the running. Two will win the game. Everybody all set? Here we go. John doesn't trust banks. He keeps his money blank. Did you hear that, Geeta? John doesn't trust banks. He keeps his money blank. We are waiting, Arlene.
I'm so sorry, I was writing history.
Okay, now Arlene is ready, so we'll call on Geeta and get her response.
Well, my first response was under his bed, so I'll stick with it.
Under his bed. Okay, that's Geeta's answer. Let's find out what happens. Remember, you need one to stay in the game, two to win. Della.
Do you know why you didn't want to say that? Because I was sending you a thought, and you got in the right room, in the right object, but I said the mattress.
Under the mattress. No match there. No, under the mattress is a little different than under the bed, because, you know, under the mattress could be between the inner spring and the spring. Under the bed is
right
on
the... Don't be like that!
Oh, well, I have to explain why you can't score that.
I think you've told us enough about beds.
Richard, what do you say?
Under the bed. I said he keeps his money in his sock.
In a sock.
Now he's 11 feet tall, but that's where he keeps it.
Okay. Arlene, we're looking for the word under the bed.
I think you're wrong about mattress because I sleep only on a mattress, and that's all I have, so I kept it under the mattress.
Under the mattress. Oh. I'm sorry, the judge says that does not match. Bob Barker.
I say under Arlene's mattress. That's
under the mattress. John doesn't trust banks. He keeps his money. Michael.
I was going to say under the politicians, but I said under his mattress.
Under his mattress. Now, you must match Richard Thomas or Helene will win the game. Go, Richard.
I want to see the judge. I said in his mattress.
In his mattress, so Helene is our winner. Congratulations to you. You've done well in the time you've been here. You've picked up $700, and we've certainly enjoyed meeting you. You're a very pretty lady, and we thank you for playing Match Game 73.
Thank you.
Hello there. How are you, Helene? Take a deep breath. Okay, everything's going to be all right because you're going to have a go at the super match now. You know how that works?
Mm-hmm, I sure do.
Okay, now we polled a previous studio audience and we got their best response to this. Easter blank.
Easter blank. Now, the answer given most frequently by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most common answer, $250, and the third, $100. Whatever you win up here is yours to keep. More important than that, it gives you a chance to play for 10 times that amount. That is, if you match the $500 response, you'll have a shot at $5,000. Now, these lovely panelists here are going to help you. Choose three celebrities one at a time, then get their suggested responses. Okay. Whom will you begin with?
Start with Bob.
You'll start with me, and you're a winner. It can be only one thing, Easter egg.
Easter egg is Bob Barker's Easter response. Egg. Okay, that's one. Number two?
Michael.
Easter bonnet.
Easter bonnet is what she says. All right, which other celebrity do you want to work with?
Richard.
Easter bunny.
Easter Bunny, he says. The audience seems to like his answer. Now, you can choose one of those, Easter Egg, Easter Bonnet, Easter Bunny, or think up one of your own, but right now we call for one response.
I'll try Easter Bunny.
You'll try Easter Bunny. All right, let's find out how the audience responded. That's the answer that Richard Thomas gave you. We are looking for Easter Bunny. May we see the $100 response? Easter Parade. Well, that's connected with the Easter Bunny, but not quite it. We're still looking for the Easter Bunny. May we see the $250 response? Easter Sunday. Well, Helene, we're all around it, but we haven't got it yet. Here is your third and last chance. Looking for Easter Bunny, the $500 response. You got Easter Bunny. Very good, Helene. Congratulations. Mr. Thomas gave it to you, didn't he? Very good, Richard. And he's happy that you're happy. Okay, you've got the $500, and that means now you're going to have a go at $5,000, or 10 times that amount. Now, to collect the $5,000, you must match one of our celebrities and match that star on a head-to-head basis. Turn around, take a look at him, and now pick a celebrity.
How can I help but choose Richard again?
Okay.
That might have been your first mistake.
All right, now I'll get the question. Here it is. He will write his response to this. You face me as he's writing, as you're doing, and here we go for $5,000. Tiny blank. Tiny blank. All right, she's got her fingers crossed. He's finished writing, and now we'll call on you, Helene, to give us your response to Tiny blank.
Tiny Tim.
Tiny Tim is what she said. Okay, Richard, for $5,000, your answer, please.
God bless us, everyone.
Got the $5,000. We do congratulate you. I know you're very, very excited. Gives you a total of $5,600 altogether. You can, you're still a champion. You're going to meet another player. And I guess it's time to meet your new challenger right now. There's Joan Curtis.
Hello, Joan Curtis. All right, you want to step back up there, Helene? Helene, there's Joan Curtis, Helene Harrington, our current champion. Joan, it's a pleasure to have you with us. Would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm a housewife, also married to a policeman, and I have two daughters.
Wait a minute, you are also married to a policeman, as Helene is?
Yes.
And where do you live?
In Downey.
Is that anywhere near where you
are?
No,
there's conflict there.
There is conflict, okay. Okay, Joan, nice to have you with us. Good luck to you. Briefly, what you're going to do here is you'll be answering questions, trying to match each of our six celebrities. You'll have two chances. The one who matches the most celebrities at the end of the second round wins, gets $100, and the opportunity to go on to the super match where you can win over $5,000, as Helene Harrington did right now. The challenger makes the first selection, so we'll go right to round one, Joan, and ask you to make a pick, please.
I'll pick B.
B. Okay, here it is. We're starting a new game, so everybody plays. This is it. Mary is accident prone, so she always carries a blank with her. Did you hear that, Jones? Mary is accident prone, so she always carries a blank with her. All celebrities ready? Now, Joan, we'll call for your response to this. She always carries a...
I'll say first aid kit.
A first aid kit with her. Well, let's see if we score with that. John. Now, don't cry, Della. Don't cry.
Well, I'm going to cry because I got half of it. I got eight, but I said Band-Aid.
A Band-Aid. Mary's accident-prone, so she always carries a Band-Aid with her. Richard Dawson, what'd you say?
Oh, please don't let the police bust me. I said she always carries a policy.
A policy.
An accident policy.
An accident policy. All right, we're looking for a first aid kit, Arlene.
I'm afraid this just fits in the kit, and that's all. Band-Aid.
A Band-Aid. Okay, no match there. Let's see if we score with Bob Barker.
With both of them married to policemen, there is no way for us to come out of this, of course. But I was dealing in more serious accidents. I said a crutch.
Carries a crutch. Just in case.
Just in case.
Okay, Michael Learned, what does she carry?
I was torn between a crutch and a bandage.
And a bandage. We still don't have a first aid kit. Let's see if we get it from Richard Thomas.
I said Band-Aid.
A Band-Aid. So we didn't get any matches there at all, Joan. We'll go to Helene Harrington's half of this round right after this. Now we're in the middle of round one here. Shall we finish it? And with this assignment for Helene, everyone participates. Here it is, celebrities. Before an actor goes on stage, he usually checks his blank.
Oh, he does.
Before an actor goes on stage, he usually checks his blank.
I don't think that's fair, right?
Spell it down here.
I know what it means.
I believe they're all ready, so we'll call on Helene and get her response. Before an actor goes on stage, he usually checks his...
hair?
His hair. All right, she looks a little skeptical about that answer. And no wonder. Look who we're dealing with over here. Well, let's find out. Della, what do you say?
She said his hair.
His hair. That's
his hair.
She said his hair. She said hair.
No, dialogue.
His dialogue. Okay, checks his dialogue. So there's no match there. Richard, we're looking for hair.
Richard,
what do you say?
Be clean, please.
Well, before I give my answer, I must check my... zipper.
Okay. Arlene, we're looking for the answer hair.
Mine's clearer than his. Lines.
Check his lines. Okay, he runs his lines a little bit. Bob Barker, before an actor goes on stage, what happens?
I don't know about an actor, but before a television MC goes on stage, he checks his fly.
Check what you want to check. I'll check.
All right. Michael, what do you say?
I'm glad you said it first. Fly.
I suddenly feel much closer to her, you know?
Please, not in front of the children.
What a thing for a mother to say.
Yeah. What do you say, Richard?
I had my fly sewn up. I check my lines.
I don't look now, but your lines are
sewn up. I think his mother better have a talk with his boy. That's right.
I've got to go on.
Don't just go on, Gene. There comes times.
Are you ladies ready for round two? Here we go. All right, the challenger makes a selection. So at the end of round one, we have no score. Neither one of you is matched. So here we go. Round two, Joan.
I'll try A this time.
A is what she wants this time. Since no one has matched in the first round, everyone participates. Here we go.
I matched Dick.
That's true. John was blank the night he proposed. John was blank the night he proposed. Wrong. Okay, everybody ready over there. Joan Curtis, may we have a response from you? John was...
well, mine was drunk, so I'll go.
Are you saying in front of America that your husband was?
It was only time.
Oh, just a little bit.
Yeah, right.
So you want to say what?
Drunk, intoxicated.
Drunk or intoxicated the night he proposed. All right, that's her response, and that's it. Now, we'll go to Della Reese and see what she said.
I was there. I saw him. He was drunk.
He was drunk. Okay, Richard.
I didn't mind that, but he was on duty and driving at the same time, drunk.
Oh, boy. Arlene?
I think we've all had the same experience, dear. Drunk.
Doing well with that answer, Joan. John was blank the night he proposed, Bob.
So was I. Drunk.
Okay, now let's go to Michael Learned. What do you say?
I said nervous.
Nervous. Okay, no match there. And we're looking...
terrified.
He was terrified the night he proposed. So you've picked up four matches, okay? And now, as we go to Helene Harrington's end of the round, I point out to you, you must match four celebrities to stay in the game. Five, however, will win it for you. You matched no one last time around, so everyone plays. Here it is for Helene. Name someone whose picture is often on the front page of the newspaper. Name someone whose picture is often on the front page of the newspaper. You need four to stay in the game. Five, however, will win it since this is the last round. Okay, now, Helene, we'll get your answer.
Richard Nixon.
Richard Nixon is her response. Delarice, may we see your response?
This is my response.
Richard Nixon is your response. There's one match for you. Someone whose picture is often on the front page of the newspaper, Richard.
Richard?
I just hope I never see a number under it. No, I said I hope I never would.
And Arlene Francis.
Nixon.
All right, three you go. It's 4-3 at this moment. One more to tie it. Let's see if Bob Barker ties the score for you.
Nixon.
He does indeed. One more, Helene, and you win the game. Michael.
Right on, Michael.
And you won it. Okay. You're not leaving prematurely, are you?
Yeah.
I just want to point out, Joan, that we have a gift for you backstage, and we also have our most sincere thanks for playing Match Game 73. Get back with this lovely lady in a moment or so. First, we've got this for you. All right, this is the second time this lady, Helene Harrington, has been here. She knows what's going to happen. You're going to have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. Are you ready?
I am.
Okay, here we go. We polled a previous studio audience and got their best response to this. Count blank. Count blank. Now, the answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second, $250. And the third, $100. The celebrities are going to help you. You know, whatever you win here is yours to keep. More important, then you can go on and try for 10 times that amount. So if you match the $500 response, remember, you've done that once already, so you know all about. Now, let's turn around here to these celebrities. They're going to help you. Remember, you'll choose three, one at a time, and get their responses, and then make a choice after that. Here we go.
Della?
You know I'm going to say Count Basie.
You're going to say Count Basie.
Yeah, I'm going to say Count Basie.
Okay, and another celebrity?
Richard?
Another fine musician, Count Dracula.
Count Dracula, you say. Okay, that's two responses.
And Arlene.
And Arlene, if you can stop laughing at Richard Dawson long enough, no. Tell us.
I was with Dracula there for a bit. Count me out.
Count me out.
All right. Well.
Okay, so there you've got three responses from your celebrities. Count Basie, Count Dracula, and Count Me Out. Now, you may choose one of those or give us one of your own if you like. What would you like to do?
I thought of Count Basie first off.
Count Basie was the first thing that came to your mind. All right, that's it. That's the one Delarice gave you. And here we go now. We are looking for Count Basie. May we see the $100 response? Count your blessings. Okay, it's not there. Still looking for Count Basie. May we see the $250 response? Count Dracula. Richard gave you that one. Okay, here is your third and last chance. Looking for Count Basie. May we see the $500 response? Countdown.
Oh, I'm
sorry, Helene. Were you thinking of that one?
Countdown.
Oh.
I guess we're... You're what?
Della and I are disappointed.
You're all disappointed. Well, okay. So there it is, countdown, and we'll come back to Helene Harrington right after this. Now, when we next meet again, our champion will be back, Helene Harrington, and she is going to meet another contender, and I hope you'll be able to join us at that time. Now, I'd like to say goodbye to these people. Your performance was absolutely splendid, and I thank you, one and all. Did you have a good time?
No, because it should have been Basie.
It will be.
I'm going to write him, and I'm going to tell him. They don't use your name on that super match when they say count. I'm going to tell him.
We'll see what we can do about that. We thank you all for joining us this time and hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are a timely gift from West Clock, the 17-jewel man's calendar wristwatch, water-resistant case, and radial brush dial. From West Clock's Italy Industries Company. And a supply of Adolph's meat marinade works in just 15 minutes to give meat deep-down gourmet flavor and juicy tenderness. Adolph's 15-minute meat marinade. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations.